crying baby. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Speaker, you are a crying baby. You, Deputy Minority Leader, keep quiet and take the notes and report me at the appropriate time. Mr.
Honorable Majority Leader, I wonder why the leaders are making life difficult for me, the deputy leaders. After I rule, you go and invite him in by making a comment which is unacceptable. Please withdraw the crybaby comment.
Mr. Speaker, he has a white beard. He's not a crying baby. I've withdrawn it. So sit down. I've withdrawn. You are not a crying baby again. It's okay. Which one again? I'll withdraw. Which one? Yeah, you should keep quiet. Mr. Speaker, I've withdrawn. You should keep quiet. I've withdrawn. You should keep quiet. A crying old man. I've withdrawn that one too. So, Mr. Speaker, we have introduced this electronic levy, the e-levy. Mr. Speaker, we've made it clear that this levy will serve two purposes. Two. One, we are going to invest part of the funds in the private sector. Mr. Speaker, Kwame Agbodia on his feet in his argument contended that government should never dream of absorbing the many unemployment youth in the public sector, and that he contends that there should rather be a space in the private sector. Honorable Agbodia, the question you've asked, the answer is in the e-levy. Yeah. Kwame Agbodia, the answer is in the e-levy.
Yeah.
Because in that e-levy, opportunities are being created. Opportunities are being created from the district level. Young entrepreneurs who need 10,000, those who need 50,000, and this time it's being structured through the banks so that they can also start their own business. After all, the greatness of America rests on the private sector when they talk about the American dream, because the American government puts money in the pocket of the people. What are we seeing here? So, Mr. Speaker, no matter how you criticize, no matter how you poison the minds of Ghanaians, this government means well. We shall remain resolute. We shall not be carried away by your propaganda. The e-levy has come. Embrace it. It will benefit the people of Ghana. In one breath, Atufosu will argue loudly in this house that our tax, the debt burden, we are taking too much loans. Government says, yes, we are departing from that. We want to look within, expand the tax net, and make sure that the ordinary Ghanaian, all of us, contribute. That one too, you say no. But I can understand. Your fear is that government would get sufficient resources to develop the country. You are afraid that when things are done, you may not have the opportunity of coming back to power. That is all why you are making noise. And upon your budget today, I want to tell you, the youth of Adaku, who have entrepreneurial energy in them, are going to have an equal chance of benefiting. And if you come and vote, if you vote against this bill, trust me, prosperity, your people who elected you into this house, will never forgive you, Kwame Agbodia. And all those who are thinking like you, this e-levy is a savior.
Yes.
The road construction, you and I know. Now, Mr. Speaker, let's face facts. Let's deal with the real issue. By the grace of God, one of you chairs the road fund in this house. The burden there, the contractors who have worked and have no payment, they don't know even when they will be paid. Mr. Speaker, I can tell you that they are so burdened, people's businesses are collapsing. Now, a structured way to deal with the problem is to get funds, reliable funds, dedicated funds, over and above what you're already getting, so that contractors can be paid. We fall questions for road construction in this house more than any other department or ministry. If you check our records, every MP is asking for roads. Roads. Mexicano are here. Where is the money?
Tell them.
Where is the money? We don't want to borrow. We are not going to take loans. But you see, Mr. Speaker, NDC argues and argue with mischief, with respect. With respect because, Mr. Speaker, with mischief because in all their submissions, they have not told us what the alternative plan is. And today, you are led by your deputy minority leader. I am challenging your leadership. Tell us what your alternative plan is. Tell us, because in 2016, you raised your hands up in despair and said you could do nothing. That is what you said. And it's the same stock of politicians who are today making noise and telling us that our policies are not good. So tell us what your policies are. But Mr. Speaker, the time has not come yet. We have confidence in the head of our economic management team.
Yeah.
Dr. Bawumia.
You have one more minute. Kindly conclude.
We have confidence in him.
Leader, I'm not...
We have confidence in him.
Please, let him conclude so you can answer. Conclude, please conclude.
A point of information to the Honorable Deputy.